Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. Today let's look into a new topic, that is the decorators. So firstly, to understand the decorator concept, we have to learn three different things. That is, functions are called as first class objects. We need to learn why functions are called as first class object. What is a first class object and why functions are called first class objects. Secondly, we need to know about the LEGB rule. So this will cover it in the next session. And thirdly, we need to know about the closures, which will be covered in the consecutive sessions. So for today, to learn more on decorators, firstly, let's try to understand why functions are called as first class objects. So functions are called as first class objects because they behave like any other object, like a list or an integer. So functions behaves in a similar fashion as how list or integer behave. And we can pass function as an argument to another function. So friends, till now we used to pass variables like int, float, string to as an argument to the function. Now we can pass the function itself as an argument to another function. And thirdly, we can return function from another function. So till now we used to return a value like integer, string or float. So after performing some operations, the function used to return an int or a float or a string. So now we can return a function itself from another function. Fourthly, we can assign a function to a variable. How we assign list or integer to a variable, we can assign a function also to a variable. Since all these criteria get satisfied, we can call function as first class objects. Now let's look into it practically. There is a function called add which takes in two arguments a comma b and it returns a plus b. There is another function mult which takes two parameters a comma b and returns a into b. Then we have calc which takes function as an argument. So calc is a function. Calc itself is a function and it takes another function as an argument. And it is our result equal to func 10 comma 3. So we are calling this function. Whatever argument is being passed to the function, that particular function gets called and it prints the result. So now all these three are function definition. The function does not call by the definition. Only when there is a call to the function gets called. So here we are having the call statement. I'm saying calc of add. So calc is my function. I'm calling my function. And what is the argument I'm passing? I'm passing another function as an argument to my calc function. So calc of add. Calc is a function. Add is also another function. So a function is passed as an argument to the calc function. So func will now have the value add result equal to add 10 comma 3. So it is calling the function add. This particular add, a will have the value 10, b will have the value 3 and it returns a plus b. So the result becomes 13. Now in my second calling statement, I am calling the function calc but mult as the function argument. So I am passing another function called mult as an argument to the calc function. So now func will have the value equal to mult. So result is equal to mult 10 comma 3. So it performs the multiplication 10 into 3 and the result would be 30. So here friends, what we have to remember is a function is passed as an argument to another function. So this is very much necessary to understand the decorator concept. So a function can be passed as an argument to another function. So passing function as an argument to another function. We have to remember this. And RES is my variable and it is having storing a function. So assigning a function to a variable. So these two points, that is we can pass function as an argument to another function, has been satisfied. And we can assign a function to a variable. So assigning a function to a variable and passing function as an argument to another function, these two scenarios has been satisfied. So we can say that it is a first class object. So now let's look into it practically. So I'm having my function called add, which takes two parameters, a comma b, and it return a plus b. Now I'm having one more function def mult, which takes a comma b as the parameters, and it returns a into b. Now let me have my calc function, calc, which takes func as the parameter, that is a function as a parameter, and my result is equal to func 10 comma 3. And then let me say print result. So all these three are the function definition. So this is the function add, this is the function mult, and this is the function calc. Without, when I run this, it won't get executed because I am not calling the function. Now let me call the function by saying calc of add. So friends, here calc is a function and I'm calling this function, and the argument which I'm passing is another function add. So function is being passed as an argument to another function. So now when I run the code, I get my output 13 because it returns a plus b, that is 10 plus 3, 13, and it prints the result equal to 13. Now when I make it as mult, the calc function is calling another function mult, and it instead of function, mult gets replaced. So result is equal to mult 10 comma 3. So this particular function gets called. A will have the value 10, B will have the value 3, 10 into 3 becomes 30, and we get the output as 30. And so here we have to remember two things. We are passing function as an argument to another function, and we can assign function to a variable. So this function has been assigned to a variable. So hope so friends, it is clear for you. These two points which come under first class objects. Now let's see how we can return a function from another function. So for this, let me have my mult, which is having x as the parameter, and within the mult function I'm having a nested function, one function within another function. So perform is my other function which is having y as the parameter, and it returns x into y, and my main function mult returns perform, that is the inner function. So the main function mult is returning the inner function which is perform. So x will have, for x equal to mult of 10, so I'm passing x will take the value equal to 10, and it returns perform. So x will have the value perform, that is the reference to the function perform. Now when I say print x of 5, it becomes perform of 5. So I am calling perform with y as 5. So it performs x into y, that is 10 into 5, and returns the value 50. We are not concerned about the result. What we need to remember here is the mult function is passing perform as the returning function. So it is returning a function. So we have to understand that the outermost function is passing the innermost function. It is returning the innermost function. So it is called as a first class object. So functions also behave like integer or list. How we can pass int or list, return a int or list, we can return a function as well. So now let's look into it practically. So initially I have my def mult of x. It's taking one parameter x. Then I'm having my inner function, which is perform, which is taking y as the parameter. Then let me return x into y. And then this will return perform. Now my multiply is equal to mult of 5. Then I say print multiply of 10. So friends, let's see what happens. Here I am having a function called mult of x. It takes one parameter x. Within this mult function, I am having one more function which is perform, which is a nested function. This perform is within the mult function. We had seen nested for loops, nested ifs. In the same way, this is nested functions. And it returns x into y. X into y, it returns the value. And this return statement is for the perform function. And now my mult function, it returns perform, that is the inner function. It is returning a function. Now I'm calling my mult function. So multiply is equal to mult of 5. So I'm calling my mult function. So x will have the value equal to 5. And this is the function definition. It does not get executed and it returns perform. So multiply, this value will have the reference to the perform function. And now when I say print, multiply will have reference to perform. So multiply will have perform of 10. So perform of 10, y takes the value 10 and it performs x into y, which is equal to 50. So the value 50 gets printed on the console. So what we have to remember over here is the mult function, the outer function, is returning the inner function. So a function is being returned. So just as we return an integer or a list, in this scenario we are returning a function itself. So function, another function. A function is returning another function. So we can say function as first class objects. So friends, hope so it is clear for you. Functions behave like any other objects like integer or list. We can pass function as an argument to another function. We can return function from another function. We can assign a function to a variable. So, since all these criteria get satisfied, we can call function as first class objects. So, hope so friends, it is clear for you. In the next session, let's cover LEJB rule and closures. So, hope so it is clear for you. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.